Between Walmart and Sam's Club, I worked in 10 different facilities. I started as a cashier. I ran stores for a while and have been from Cincinnati to here in Bentonville. I have a 4-year-old daughter. Her name is Gwen. She is extremely creative. She loves to do anything that has to do with drawing or painting. It was like 2 o'clock in the morning and Gwen came into our room. She kept saying that her ear was hurting and that she had an earache. Her pain just didn't seem to go away. It seemed to escalate. We ended up calling into Doctor on Demand. He looked at it and immediately said, "This isn't an ear infection. This is something called mastoiditis. It's a pretty severe infection that gets into the bone and into the skull." So we took her to the local children's hospital branch, checked it out. They said she's gonna need an emergency operation. It was extremely scary. I mean, they shaved part of her skull back to get the infection out of it. And that was just the beginning of her treatment. Gwen, she's just always so optimistic and always looking at everything so positive. So to watch her going through that and being in pain and being scared and not being able to take that away from her, I mean, it makes you feel powerless as a parent. She had 4 weeks of antibiotics that were administered through an IV. So she stayed there in the hospital for 30 days with my wife. There was a moment that we went into her room and we were just talking about, you know, she's in quarantine, she's sick, she just had surgery, things are as bad for a 4-year-old as they can get. And she's sitting there drawing on her table, singing, "If You're Happy and You Know It." I was riding up the elevator at the hospital to go back up to Gwen's room. And I looked over and there was a sign on the wall. And it was of all the different people who had made donations. And one of the signs said Walmart. And it immediately brought me back to those days in the stores, raising the money for our children's hospital, asking for the dollar, taking the pie in the face or being slimed, whatever it was. And it was very humbling to know that I work for a company that is raising money to help kids, to help these communities when they need it.
My name is Gwen, and I got a pick yarn. A pick yarn is something that holds your arm, but you still can move it.
She had to have shots twice a day, every day, for 6 weeks, right when we got home.
Those are the doctors that I had at the hospital.
We actually go back to the children's hospital so she can get another MRI.
They cut open my ear and shaved my bone, and there's even a skull from it.
So as long as everything's clear and good from there, she's good to go. She feels fine right now. She's acting back to herself.
It's a fun place because there was a playroom downstairs.
When it comes to raising money for the hospital, thank you to everybody who is going to donate. You've made an impact in my life personally. $1, it may not seem like a lot to you. It could be the change in your purse or the change in your pocket that you have. But I can tell you, after being in the hospital, $1 is 2 canisters of Play-Doh. And sometimes those 2 canisters of Play-Doh were the thing that made Gwen's day.
Usually it was Play-Doh and make toys and painting stuff.
Gwen has picked up this phrase when we talk and I'm like, "Oh man, this day is just terrible." And she'll say to me, "Is it a bad day or is it just a bad moment?"
Thanks for talking. Bye.